rights at pleasure, right? Well, we might be hard-working people in a country good for business, but pleasure is what we excel at. After all, in Europe, we are among the Southerners, and that makes us close to the Greeks, the Italians, and the Spaniards. One thing we surely have in common: we appreciate good fun and good times. And here's where we find these. To start with, there is our capital, Sofia. It is a dynamic city with its own special atmosphere, or at least, all our guests say so. They all go for the warm and friendly people, the great food, the vibrant nightlife, and the outdoor coffee culture. On top of that, we've still managed to preserve our capital as one of the greenest cities on the continent, with an abundance of parks, some of them both botanical and architectural landmarks. Oh yeah, if you prefer to experience the green under a decent shroud of snow, Sofia is situated right at the bottom of a pretty high mountain called Vitosha. So I think you get it, a fresh air hike or some skiing in your lunch break is a pretty viable option, isn't it? Then there is our second biggest city, the old Plovdiv. And we do mean all. Forget Roman Athens, they're babies. Plovdiv was recently officially proclaimed by archaeologists to be the oldest town in Europe and the fifth oldest in the world. Enough said about the big cities. Just an hour-long drive out of the capital may take you to a place with a name hard to pronounce and sites hard to forget. Try this, Koprivštica. Hard, huh? It will be even harder not to get enchanted with the place, still keeping the charm of Bulgaria's own 19th century Renaissance. And it's just one of all the authentic small places we have around here. Eco farms, old wooden houses, amazing home-cooked food, and stunning 360-degree vistas. Destinations for a year-round schedule of adventures. And the nature. Every country takes pride in its nature, and we are no exception to this rule. It is so stunning and diverse that we actually wrote our national anthem about it. We already mentioned the Black Sea, whose sunny, sandy, and beautiful coastline is often referred to as the Bulgarian Riviera. Perfect to visit from May until October, it has numerous places for all kinds of tastes. From big, sunny resorts to places where time has stopped and living is calm and slow-paced. So you can choose to get to a beach party or just relax in the virgin beaches, far north or south, or try all of it. Even more, all of those you can explore with a yacht, as Bulgaria has 8 certified yacht ports. You can even go golfing just above the surf line. Bulgaria's strive to become a premier golfing destination has provided for several perfect golf courses that come with first-class facilities, dining and accommodation. And if you're not so crazy about the sun-sand-waves combination, how about going to the Switzerland of the Balkans? Some people call us this way because of the several extremely beautiful and different mountains we have. They're host to ski resorts with all the necessary modern facilities and, of course, perfect snow from January until April. The numerous ski runs with all levels of difficulty attract crowds of skiers and snowboarders from around the Balkans, the UK and Russia. Finally, did you know that next to Japan and Italy, Bulgaria is the country in the world with most mineral springs? Hot, cold, big and small, many are utilized in different spa and wellness resorts. Still need more reasons to try all this life? Let's check some history then. Now, the thing with history is every country has it. Whether long, short, glorious or not so glorious, still it's what you can still see of it today that makes a country's history really interesting. To put it straight, as a state, Bulgaria has more than 13 centuries of history. A lot? Well, try this then. Actually, people have been here for more than 7,000 years. Traces of prehistoric cultures on our lands go back as far as the Bronze Age. And we have a cave called Magurata, which has the biggest collection of prehistoric drawings in Europe. So go there and you can check how we started to learn drawing. Not bad for beginners, huh? Some centuries later, we had already made a great progress. This is a vault the Thracians built and painted, and yes, they were good. So good, actually, that they even got an honorable mention in Homer's Iliad, That's why so many Bulgarian extras starred in Troy. Apparently, Thracians were also very keen on gold and very good at treasure making. Bulgaria was home to the world's first gold craftsman, who left for us to discover the oldest golden treasures in the world. From then on, we kept on turning our whole country into an arts gallery. Greeks and Romans left us columns, steles, and mosaics. Then for some time, it all turned into tremendous icons, frescoes and murals, churches and monasteries. All in all, we have no less than 7 cultural sites in UNESCO's World Heritage List and hundreds of other undescribable, must-see historical and archaeological landmarks. Well, for the last 2 centuries, we came upon the idea of putting all the emerging art into specially designed places, so now you can enjoy marvelous art collections in the galleries of every city and some small towns as well. Well, alright, you got the idea. We were nicely cultured and interesting people back then, but what about today? I already mentioned it, but let's go through it again. You cannot have a country with a booming and interesting life without the right people to live it. So, here we are. Our dominant religion is Orthodox Christian, like Greeks and Russians, but we celebrate Christmas on the 25th of December, like Catholics. We speak Bulgarian and we use the Cyrillic alphabet, which we invented. Now, it is also the 3rd official alphabet in the European Union, along with the Latin and the Greek. A simple thank you sounds and looks like this. Bogodaria. It's pretty much hell for foreigners, and it gets even worse when we start nodding. Yes, it does. In Bulgaria, shaking your head is affirmative, and nodding means no. No, I have no idea why. At least there is no confusion with the number of kisses when you are being introduced to someone, because we simply offer a firm handshake and direct eye contact. Family is very important for us, and much of our society is based around it. We are also extremely amiable and open to foreigners, and it's a matter of honor for us to be hospitable. Oh, and finally, the weather. In Bulgaria, you can enjoy 4 fantastic seasons, beautiful blooming spring, reasonably hot and dry summer, lovely long autumn, and relatively mild and snowy winter. The average yearly temperature is 14 degrees, and we are happy to have an average of 100 days of sunshine per year. To sum up, it turns out that Bulgaria is a great country to work, live, have a family, and have fun. Interested? Well, why not come around? Even if you decide to stay for much longer, we have something to offer. The new Bulgarian legislation provides a host of privileges to foreign investors who decide to combine their investments with residence and citizenship here. To put it simple, not only is there a special program to support your investments, but also legislative incentives for those who come here to do business and for their families. They can obtain a permanent residence status which doesn't require their presence in the country for any period of time. That is, if you manage to remain disenchanted by all the interesting possibilities around here. Take a minute to think about it, and then simply take the plane. And of course, if you need anything, just get in touch with us. So, it's all Bulgaria, it's all here. Bye, see you around soon.